Hello viewers, welcome back to Endless Legend. It's Endless Legend time again. So, this is the known world. You will notice that it is divided into roughly equal portions us and not us. Obviously, there are many things beyond our current sight. And in time, we will roll over them like an inviting orange tide. When last we left off here, we had just built some new replacement units for our army. Okay. We may as well just merge these guys. So this army just needs to stay put and be healthy. And keep these cities defended while they recover. And search these ruins. These guys have a lot of responsibilities. Oh, they couldn't search from there. 20 dust water. I love dust water, but it's going to take a lot more than 20 to power a booster for us. I want to hit that ruin too while we're waiting. Oh, what am I doing? Screw that, we'll pillage. I love pillaging. Oh, what else is there? Oh, there's riders. Riders who get to search ruins. Defeat some Hernos or some Tedike. I think you get different rewards based on which one you defeat, and I don't know which one is supposed to, what the rewards are, so I don't know which one to do. And on the Seer, a level 5 hero. I think that probably what's happened here is that a civilization has sold a hero. Oh, wow. I really want that guy. We're actually in a position to make that happen, too. We make a lot of money per turn. Alright, I'm going to spend no more gold right now. This is kind of a lot of dudes. Well, Tedike have free counter and Hernas don't. So, decision made. Shouldn't be a problem. 25 Titan Bones and one item. I really wish they would just tell you right there what the item was. I guess just chill in this space. And let's go see. This is the one I want. You see, I thought about it that time. Actually, it might be a thing that I can only see on heroes anyway. Where's my big army? The Eye of the Hernas. Plus 15 initiative, plus initiative, improved initiative 2, which is another 20% initiative. That's actually pretty cool. That's a good trinket. I really like our hero having high initiative plus free counter. It would cost 30 dust to equip that. It can wait a turn. I want to make sure I can hire that that hero. Oops. I keep hitting enter to end the turn, which it doesn't do that in this game. So we do need to maybe stop building glass steel troops so much. Possibly. So watchtowers don't really serve a purpose in this city. It's already pretty burrowed out. You know what we'll do is we'll create 2 dredges because we have that quest that is reliant on there being 2 dredges. The capital can have other concerns. And we'll start buying stuff out in the cities at a higher rate once we are not once we are not so actively searching for other things to do here. So I need to make some kind of shape out of this that isn't so terrible. Oh! You know, we have access to special stuff. So the effects of this winter could be some interesting stuff. This would suit me best, I think. So we'll check in again as winter draws closer and try to make sure that this is still winning. Because last time somebody switched it up on us with prayer, and it really screwed me up. So let's have a quick look at our cities. Where would we get significant benefit out of? Because I remember talking about using these things. So where would we get significant benefit out of our special district types? Well, in Balthar, we could get Moonleaf with a luxury extractor. That's pretty compelling. Here we could get Adamantian at a greater rate. That's, I think, most important. Let's do that. Let's put this in front. Do this. This is really important. Yeah. It would cost 20 to unlock another one, so I wouldn't even be able to build it. And I did not solve my core problem of the fact that Renard doesn't have anything to build. But I can now make a burrow and then build a strategic intensifier here, which is actually going to be pretty valuable. And then we'll complete the triangle at some point. I do not know which direction my army is going to move in yet. Defeat an avenging army for some mithrite. Okay, I assume this will be trivial. Good work, team. Hey, free mithrite. Victory and the unfortunate death of innocence. 1202, so let's go buy this very talented and powerful governor. Also, we got a new quest. Who are the Yotus? With the Eye of the Hern... Ooh, there's more quest! With the Eye of the Herna's leader in your sack bag, the cloth stained red where the stump of his nerve touches the fabric, you resolve to visit the Tedike tribe who triggered the bloodshed. The Hernas deserve that much. With the head of an enemy leader as your pass, go to the Yotus to learn more about them. So, where the hell is the... Okay, well, that's kind of a long-term plan. That's really cool, though. So, one of these villages is getting new heroed. I guess it's Undand. And Om the Seer, come forth and bear witness. Because somebody has to be here in case the enemies show up. We need defense. This is pretty cool. 25 Palladian and some Yotus. So, permit me to be forgetful for a moment. Okay, we will soon have smelting station technology. And then right after that, weapons tech. So, my guy's injured. I don't want him to die. I think we're going to hold off on attacking. Just chill, right there. Alright, so we have some reinforcements coming. Swing down to an angle where I can control the motion of my units a little more finely. Are these guys coming for us? I'll fight you. You ran out of movement. Okay. I'll fight you, you know, in the near future, whenever. You know, whatever's convenient for you. These guys cost a lot. I think that's what I'm buying next, though, is the other rider. At least one more rider. Yay. We get to present a united front right as we are approached by enemies. I think I can just auto this? Let's be safe. Okay, so they actually got a pretty powerful setup here with the archers. So it behooves us to make them come forward. With four range, 1, 2, 3, 4, yeah, nobody gets to start this far forward. I don't know why I did that. I'm just clicking arbitrarily now. We have to make them come to us a little bit. This guy's still a little too far forward. Okay. So now, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, they'll still get to hit us. But now they have to come, like, around the river a little bit at least. And then we will take our sweet revenge upon them. Yeah. Those seem fine. Most of us are interested in the Padecki. And we'll get to the archers when we can get to the archers. Alright, good. Made them split up around the river a little bit. That'll lower their... Lower their morale if they can't stand in a group and shoot at us. Go get them, guys. That was an interesting move. Oh, anything to attack the Dust Bishops, right? Oh, I should probably specify to the Dust Bishop that he is to move before attacking. Well, it turns out he wouldn't have been able to attack in any case. I was hoping to not take any more damage during this fight. Oh, nice, the Dust Bishop will heal the hero at least. That's good. Nice, and on the seer immediately gains another level. I think we're gonna make for a cold operator as quickly as possible, and then we'll come back and get other stuff. So yes, heal Dust Bishop. Poor guy. And let us advance on them menacingly. I think we're actually, you know what? Probably we're gonna break left. Just kinda, we'll head over here, hit this, and then kinda scoop around, assuming that this is the leftmost edge of their empire, of course. I guess it could be even worse than that. Let's at least have two riders rolling around. And in addition, let's have a quick look at output. Okay, the capital is still the city of greatest output, so dust refinery. 1618. All right, that's actually, you know, not that many turns. We're doing okay. Some suspect a curse from an angry god of love. The Alchemic Institute has been constructed. Well, we certainly never had a shot at that. By Pink, shockingly enough. Okay. I'm very curious to get this, because we're totally going to. Our hero is fighting constantly. He's going to get his level. Let's move this way. Ooh, a golden tree. Neat. Also, chromatic land. Also, 7 units in a garrison with 200 fortification points. At least we're not very far from our city, so we can, double back if we have to. So what do we add here? 1285? Okay. Two riders might be sufficient to start, policing the field here. Although, maybe I should hire a hero. Maybe I should delay things a little bit and hire a hero for this army. Are there any cavalry heroes available? There aren't. In fact, there are no heroes. Oh, well, you're pretty fast. You have 5 move. Okay. Army boost 2. Okay, no relevant stuff. Yeah, I think we're going to hire this guy. He's got 5 move. He's got army boost 2, which is a nice all-around boost. And you get a lot of extra value out of an army just by attaching a hero to it. And this can be our defense army, since it moves so quickly and everything. So let's equip him with stuff. The finest in armor made out of the most basic metals that we know how to make. And also breakwall, probably. Plus 20% defense, plus 10% damage. Damage is a really good stat. And then, I'm actually going to go, I know that I was trying to cut down on the usage of glass steel, but the initiative is really valuable. 2 initiative versus 20 initiative. You take a little bit of a hit on the damage and attack relative to titanium. Titanium weapons are better at actually dealing damage, but for a ranged unit, high initiative is really important. And then, improved movement 3, so that he can not be slowing everybody down. And he's already got sharp sense because he's got a shield. Yeah, we'll give him this. That's awesome for him. And army damage boost. Okay, not cheap to equip, but this army should now be quite capable of dealing with these minor factions. We're going to get these guys taken care of by any means necessary, and then we got to build watchtowers. I suppose a watchtower right here is not useless. Those are fairly expensive. Alright, I just want to make sure that we keep our faction quest moving. I don't know exactly what the rewards of the ending parts are, and I don't remember even really what the middle parts are, despite the fact that I played a game as Broken Lords really not that long ago. But it seems important to me to do this. And let the siege begin. Right, we're at 42 points of siege damage per turn now. I guess that value is right here. I don't have to... so that's good. Theret and Undant have now actual armies of militia to support each other with. Theret has a powerful governor. Although our powerful governor is not equipped with stuff. I guess that's something to consider. Maybe they give us an easy quest? Oh! We didn't have to destroy that. All we had to do was... I knew that. Well, embarrassing. Anyway, quest complete. Die. Yeah, I feel a little silly. So how much are heroes right now? In the 700s. I want to buy a hero for Undaunt, too. And actually... or wait. Undaunt is where my hero is. I want to buy a hero for that other one. And actually, I think I'm going to outfit him real quick, too. I know this isn't going to be the cheapest, but I don't want this city getting captured. He is in a position to make the city not get captured, potentially. So the question is, would I rather him have... Infantry Slayer and 30 initiative, or... Oh, sorry about that. Knocking my microphone around. Or should I try to give him sweep strike back to take advantage of... Well, he can't have break wall if he has that, so I guess we'll just go sword and we'll hope. He's not a staff user. We don't have any heroes in our army who are staff users. We have a cool staff if we ever hire one. And then while we're here, also, I think we're going to do that. Okay, improve our output even a little bit more. And Renar can build dredges, I guess? Actually, Renar will totally handle it. Don't even worry about it, Lidera. I'm trying to be vigilant over here. I want to start moving my hero back if we see any interference. Oh, that's right. And we get a hero for this step of the faction quest. That's really good. That's right. We didn't like this guy. This guy was like, "Hey, let's vampire everyone." And we were like, "Oh, is that a good idea? I don't know, man." I do not remember what it was that stymied me on my faction quest. Assign him to a city for 10 turns and build up a district or city center to level 2 in that time. Oh, yeah. And then that thing gives us dust when we do combat, and that's awesome. Okay. Welcome, Martin. We eventually have to use him as a commander, don't we? Doesn't he have to go out in the field? I'm gonna do this. Okay, so... this city does have enough population that we could... well, enough population, you know, with us being able to buy more, I mean. That we could push pretty hard. So 16, 18... Did I equip him for combat? Actually, yeah, let's do that. The two cities are close enough together that they will defend each other. Having two heroes in the field is going to dramatically increase our chances of success. Oh, also, he can equip the quivering circlet, so that's pretty good. This is not available to us right now. I have to remember to come back and do that in a turn. Why not? Okay. So that's done now. We don't really need these guys for anything. I guess pearl gathering is their job now. And they have 8 moves so they can... oops. That's right, there's a giant cliff face. They have 8 moves so they can report to the front quickly if they are needed. Reactivate our die booster. Oh, and that's right, we are building up a wine booster for just this reason. That'll help us. What are we at now? 1052 a turn. Very nice. This is happening. In a couple of turns, we're going to have the ability to make better weapons. We should get this now. We should also help out Therat. Because I want more... what do you call it? Want more quest progress. So let's go pearl hunting. We know there's lots of pearls down here. Alright, these guys almost have their garrisons completely regenerated. The army from Gildren will be attacking us this turn. Yep, there it is. Theret needs more stuff in the queue. Wow, Theret actually has a huge number of river tiles. I have to remember that. Wow, has there been an unexplored ruin down here this whole time? Crazy. Okay, so army ignores the movement penalties from terrain difficulty. Get more pearls. Plus X attack, where X is the percentage of life that the target is missing. But it's just the hero, right? Yeah, it doesn't affect the whole army. This, if you max this out, it stacks additively, and it gives you a reduction of 100% on the retreating health penalty. You can just disengage however you feel like you should, whenever you feel like you should. That's very interesting to me. But we're going to start up this, we're going to get all that good stuff that's in the range tree. Sorry if that's boring, because I know I do kind of the same hero builds all the time. It's just that they're really good. Alright, battle. So, lots of battle to be done here. Apparently we're very close to another city, and we're going to be probably seeing their reinforcements here. Oh, indeed we are! Well, that's good. It won't be a long walk to the next conquer. And, even better, we'll be still in range of this city while sieging that one, so they won't be able to just walk a Berdecki army up behind us and retake the city. So how do I want to do this? The Berdeckis are annoying, archers are also annoying, and there's going to be so many troops funneling in. We definitely want to start as close to them as possible. So I want to do a gather around the Dust Bishop thing. Probably not. I think this should be sufficient to keep the Dust Bishops clear for a turn, and we'll figure it out after that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah. I think everybody should focus up on these guys. Like, just do damage. Please, no stuns. Alright. The first attack of the battle seems like it always stuns, no matter what. And again, I would like to remind you, just casually, that it's not possible for them to reach 50% stun chance. So we should see, fewer than half of their stuns stick, but we always see significantly more than half. It's usually in the neighborhood of like 60 to 75% of their attacks cause stuns, which is a little silly. And then it reduces as the battle goes on. It's just that their first round attacks have a tremendously higher stun rate than could be expected. Yeah, honestly, I think we do keep ignoring the archers. They just don't do that much damage. And of course, the stun goes off on the Dust Bishops, because it would be a shame if they were able to do stuff in battle ever. 74 damage, wow. Yep, my entire damn army is stunned. Hey, I thought all you guys were targeting the cavalry. What's going on? I mean, like, the Dust Bishops are gonna die because that entire half of my army got stunned. There needs to be something that, honestly, there needs to be something that makes your unit stun immune. It should take up an important armor slot, and it should not give stats, so that there's a significant trade-off for using it, and it would still be objectively correct to use it in all circumstances if you're facing a stunning army. It's frustrating that that's the case. But you guys have to focus up. I keep hitting enter like that's going to cause the thing to happen. Yep, and now everybody's going to gang up on the Dust Bishops to make sure that they die before their stun runs out. Stunned. Brand new stuns. Gotta keep those stuns coming. There we go, that's a much better target for you. Too late for the poor Dust Bishops, though. I think what's going to end up happening here is that we're going to have to bring in... the first army is going to have to be entirely stalwarts. And we're going to have to bring in a second army of Dust Bishops that arrives after the first army is in play and tangled up with the enemy. Because otherwise, they will do absolutely anything in their power to focus our Dust Bishops, and it is, it's expensive. We're losing them all the time. The only way to not lose the Dust Bishops in the first few rounds, it seems like, is to distort the entire army around protecting them, and that makes us way less effective in normal combat. What? Did I seriously leave somebody on... First of all, did I seriously leave somebody on attack militia? And secondly, how did they get on attack militia as their orders in the first place, considering that I definitely didn't have anybody with those orders the previous round? Where did those orders come from? Our Dust Bishop is at 30. It's not impossible that he could survive the attack that he's going to endure from this Burdecki. And it's possible that none of the ranged units will target him. Alright, well, we are losing this battle. We are not losing this battle. That is an asinine thing to do. Why would you not move forward and attack the unit? Oh, is it the last... This is the last phase? Alright, if none of the archers target our Dust Bishop, he will, against all odds, survive the battle. Cool. Heals for everybody. Alright, so we have another stalwart waiting for us in Therat. For just such an occasion. The militia are leveling up fighting with us. All heals. I did that with my action point instead of attacking, because they still have a significant number of units, and I don't want to attack with a seriously weakened force. Alright, you guys need to head back toward the front. I'm a little nervous. Oh no, wait, it's not a new turn yet. Get up here. Okay. Our primary army is being attacked again. Ooh. They have Tedicase, so we have to be wary of that. But their force is tremendously diminished, and our force is honestly in pretty good shape, our hero aside. He still gets XP when he dies in battle, right? I'm not actually sure. Oh, you're a madman. I should have given him hold position orders for a turn. Alright, well, they are desperate to dash the defenses of two of their cities against us. Which feels pretty good. This is archers, right? Yeah, focus these guys. Unfortunately, their archers don't really have the damage output necessary to kill my units. It's an attack versus defense thing, not actually a damage thing. Attack makes you deal more damage indirectly through means, arcane means. No, do this. Move to that space, then attack. If you're playing the game and you're curious how to do that, right-click on the space you want them to move to, and then while holding the right mouse button down, drag to the unit you want them to attack. That's actually a super useful thing, and I don't think that the game explains it. Alright, really great soul leeches. We're like all at full health. Why do you have so little health? Oh, he's right. This is the new guy. He's lower level than everybody else. By the way, this is a good opportunity to have a look at the levels. So this guy's level 6. He has 418 health. 76 attack, 69 damage. Granted, a little bit of the stat difference is coming from the fact that this guy's not in the hero army. But not all of it. A significant portion of it also is the level difference. Wow, 54. Their militia are much better fighters than their archers. But Soul Leech is kind. Ooh, good defense, sir. A little bit of healing out here. Kind of wish that unit hadn't done that. It's a little bit more important that we kill the archers, probably. Although I suppose the archers die easily, so maybe we don't have to focus on them so much. Alright, it's just more and more militia. If we actually manage to kill these two during this battle, I think this will be the garrison of that other city. I will have emptied two cities in a single turn. Did we leave them alive with 7 health? Is that what just happened? Oh no, actually Gildren had another 2 reinforcements coming. That is crazy. Well, take the city. We'll auto that. Oh wow, they actually did fight. I assumed that they would choose not to reinforce. So they just emptied that city. That was nice of them. Oh, Empty Belly has reached level 8. Let's pick this up. Empty Belly has reached level 8, which is important because it means that we just got a... means that we just got a legendary deed accomplished. What are you guys doing? Dust. All is dust. But like in a good way. Sorry, I said that and it sounded kind of ominous, and I meant it to be like reaffirming. All is dust, and we're cool with that, and we're happy about it. It's nice. It's a good thing. Please rush complete some buildings for me. And then, let's make you into a better-shaped city. Because our Empire approval is still kind of floating around in awkward places. We are going to complete that dredge quest eventually, and that'll help. That'll help a lot, actually. Alright, we are making some pretty okay dust. Heal for 3? Nah. So, plus 20% health regen on Empire. I don't think that this affects our... I don't think this affects our Broken Lords units, but I'm not sure of that. I guess I shouldn't have healed them. Then we could have found out. That would have been smart. They're building a Guardian. I don't realistically think I have a way of stopping that from happening, unfortunately. Is that Imperium? Ooh. I think that we are going to be occupied with Purple for the foreseeable future. They have a really serious... really serious thing going on here. Let me rush the construction of this stuff along. Actually, do this first, because there's a ton of river tiles in the city. So I didn't heal these guys. Let's see if they get any regen. Who's injured? I mean, he'll get it. It'll be good for him. Six turns. Yep. It will soon be Empire Plan time once again. We need one more burrow, and then this this stage of our faction quest will be finished. The enemy does get kind of pissy when you collect pearls. This is the first game. This is the first game where I have given precisely zero. cornered myself a little. Given zero cares. I'm trying to keep the language down. You know, I want like people to be able to watch this, even if they don't like to hear that stuff. Truth be told, I kind of cuss like a sailor in my normal everyday life, and I'm trying to get that under control. Not because it matters to me, but because it could matter to other people. And precisely because it does not matter to me, I don't derive any personal worth from whether or not I can say swear words, because I'm not 3 years old. Alright, here we go. So this will complete this step of our faction quest. Buying the citizens made us not able to auto-complete that. We'll have to do it next turn. They are building units with the serious quickness. This city's garrison was wiped out. Their militia was wiped out in the defense of Gildren. The next turn they had 3 units in their garrison, and then the turn after that they had 5. That's crazy. Oh, people are allowed to regenerate health again. That's right. That health regeneration bonus wasn't doing anything for a couple of turns. So, I don't... Yeah, that's pearls. Let's go get those pearls, I guess. I don't want to stray too far from Soth and Adina, though, because I know that Purple Army, you know... Yeah, let's not. Let's just stay over here. Actually, you know what? We have such fast movement that we can, like, we can scout around at least a little bit. Ooh, here's their capital. This would be a get. Well, we'll get to it. That city looks quite well-developed as well. And this is the western edge of their country, so I'd like to, you know, sweep from the side. If you poke up in the middle, then you have a two-front war going on, basically, and those traditionally have not been easy to fight. If real-world military history has taught me anything, and it really hasn't, because for the most part, I only know military history as it is represented in movies. It's probably, I'm going to go on a limb here and guess, not very accurate. But you know, I heard some stuff about World War II. I think a two-front war is bad. Interesting. With an army composed of only a single unit of level 4 minimum, the sleeper quest is going to give us exotic alloys this time. That's weird. Oh, we are being sieged. And attacked. Well, we have 2 well-equipped heroes. If this city gets taken, we will break off the siege and come and murder these. I mean, we're going to break off the siege and come and murder these guys no matter what happens. Renar has finished the guys. Let's go ahead and make a strategic resource intensifier right here in Theret. Alright, just trying to get all my other stuff taken care of. Is Renar where we made the dredges? Yeah. The dredges have to be in the capital for their quest, don't they? In the capital city, okay. Go forth and garrison yourselves. Alright, let's deal with this. We will manual resolve. The game gives us very little chance of survival. These Bradeckis are pretty upgraded, and they have crippling charge. A crippling charge that goes off like something like 40% more often than it should. That's frustrating. But we have militia with Cavalry Slayer 4, and the militia are not... Like, these guys have a little bit of combat experience, although I guess they're all They're all level 1, just short of level 2. Frustrating. And we'll get reinforcements from our other city's militia. I'm glad I equipped our governors with real gear, though. Okay. Sadly, we do not get to make any decisions as far as targeting goes, probably. Actually, yeah, that makes sense. Well, I should have pulled my initial forces back so that all my reinforcements would be guaranteed to be able to assist on the first turn. Okay. So we're probably going to deal pretty good damage to them. Except when we don't. I remember it's important to kill the non-hero units first most of the time. As you've seen from several instances of our battle, unless the hero's pouring out damage, it's less important to kill him. The hero has to be pouring out damage and the hero has to be pouring out damage and it has to be relatively easy to kill him in order for it to be worth doing. Like, our opponents killing our hero who has one health when he's doing like 100 plus damage a turn, absolutely good play on their parts. Alright, our other hero finally gets to enter battle. Yeah, this is going to be a total rout. I don't know what the game was thinking with that little bar all purple. We are going to lose that one militia man when their hero shoots him. No, little militia guy, no. You were the greatest of us all. Okay, their hero has a lot of defense. He's standing in a forest. I'm going to let the militia attack from below him and get my heroes to attack from above. And you can see he's ranged, so he's losing morale from being surrounded. We're going to start seeing some pretty good damage output on him, I think. So we get one more turn, we'll definitely kill him. Yeah, I'm really glad that I took the time to equip my heroes. That could have been really ugly. I don't know why this city lost all of its fortification. We didn't actually have all of our fortifications stripped. We had one guy who still had like 80 plus left. Yeah, let's keep pushing upward. Now, we'll buy this out, and that'll be the, for this city. Alright, that'll be the quest completion. Also, we can get a Moonleaf Extractor. Neat. And our army doesn't have to break off, and these guys don't really have to do anything special. Yeah, okay, things are going alright. Oh, we finished all of our important techs. Cool. So, that being the case... Oh, this is super good for us, because all of our citizens are working on dust, yeah. Obviously that. After we take Skyene, I think that it's time to upgrade our units to start using Adamantium. We'll get a little bit of build-up time. Unfortunately, Dust to Rust is on, so... Alright, we'll buy that out in a turn. Right, I just had to raise a district to level 2, right? Did I misread? Build up a district or city center to level 2. Oh, he has to be assigned there for 10 turns, right. I built up the city so quickly that we hadn't completed the other part of the quest yet. Oh, this region has Palladium too. And Moonleaf. This is crazy. This is a great region. And titanium, jeez. Yeah. People who got orders, follow your orders. We do need to get right-of-way finished in our cities. We don't have it in almost everywhere, and it's definitely hurting our ability to travel places. In fact, to such an extent that I think it's probably right to just buy it out. Do you seriously not have geomic labs, or sewer systems, or central markets, or... I've been so focused on other stuff, I have not been building up my cities the way I'm supposed to. The thing about playing without a lot of industry is that you have to be very active in construction. The cities that we're picking up have much higher industry than our native city. Okay. Oh, hold on. There's going to be fighting. Yeah, let's take care of this first. I'll get over there in time. I don't think he did. Alright, well, this is a smaller and weaker force than attacked us before. They don't have a hero, and they do have a Drider. A level 1... Not level 1, but an unupgraded Drider. This is basically a foregone conclusion. Let's go ahead and fight it out, though. We'll do it manually. Just because I don't want to have any unpleasant surprises. We do only have 20 points of fortification. That's an advantage that they didn't have before. And right on either side of the reinforcement flags. Okay, so let's all focus up one Berdecki at a time. Oh, maybe it should have been that one. No, this one's going to run more center then. There's the stun. At least the damage from the attack was eaten by the fortifications. And hey, he didn't even land his stun. What kind of Berdecki are you? This guy will... Oh, attack, actually. I thought for sure he was just going to heal. Yeah, go ahead and attack that one, because he's not going to be able to get around to deal damage to this one. Okay, well done. These Driders are completely irrelevant. I have to make sure to issue my units orders to attack the correct targets on this turn, because we can completely ignore the Drider. I mean, I guess you may as well. Yeah, and that archer is actually doing, like, okay damage against the militia. The archer has high ground, which is very helpful. It confers an attack bonus, a fairly large attack bonus, so... it looks like he's going to get to shoot first and is in fact going to get to kill that militia guy that he's been harassing the whole time. So every one of these battles we lose one militia. And then it's regenerated by the time they come back and attack again. They're just over and over again dashing their forces against a single militia. Alright. So we got our Dust Crematorium. We have to get enough influence points to set Science and Industry to level 3. I think we're good on that. We picked up a lot of cities, and our stuff is really expensive. We are not good on that. We have 1,205. We're only going to get 87 this coming turn. But we have 2 turns to make it. So I think what we're going to do is just divert everyone in every city onto influence for a turn. That sounds sane and reasonable to me. So, let's go to the city screen. I would like to move people. I know that this is not... We don't get the greatest payout for doing this, but I think it will be sufficient. I wish there was a way to do this. And maybe there is, and I just don't know about it. That has been the case with a lot of things that I wished were in the game. They already were, and I just was not aware. Okay. There we go. We'll get there this way. Okay, it's a justice here. I'm not actually fighting that. That's tedious. Okay, cool. Skyon Falls. We get some new ruins. Hello, blue guy. Don't worry. We are done. Don't take the fact that there's a necrophage at the head of my armies as a sign of anything. We're all friends here. I'll just leave this guy right here. Can these guys... Nope, they are actually out of move, so... What? Oh, new city. Right. Oh, well, this city was clearly working toward a triangle. I guess I will complete it for them. Alright, I want to make sure that these guys get moved back to a... Well, I guess the position they're in right now is relatively safe, because if they got attacked, their at would back them up. But I want to get them back over to this side. So we could pick up spies and try to get some spying done. And it's pretty powerful, actually. Spying on an enemy and then dropping their morale with the spy ability. Right before a big battle. But I don't want to spend the influence or the dust on a spy. We're doing okay the way we are. 100 dust, nice. Our hero's actually back to full health. That's how well he's doing with all that regen. Oh yeah, we should like expand this city. It's all not good. It's all two boroughs. Actually, this is a crappy location. Like, they built this city in a really weird, narrow part of the region. Actually, I guess the whole region is weird, narrow parts. Never mind. Probably, actually... start work on a dust bishop. We're gonna need it eventually. Oh, I was gonna upgrade our dudes. Let's do that. Let's go to the new army design. So it looks like Adamantian is the way. Oh, stuff's going to be incredibly expensive for a while, though. Let's just equip the hero, I guess? We're going to be able to solve this this quest, but it's going to take a little while before we're able to. So we'd like to go to the Adamantian two-hander. It actually costs more resources than we have. Never mind. We'll do it next turn. Should I be doing something with this 965 gold that I have? I guess the best thing to do would be to rush one of these if one of them is built enough for me to do that. None of them are. Oh, Balthar needs, we have a bunch more pearls now, so luxury intensifiers. Also, luxury intensifiers give us dust. Notice we're getting close up on winter now, and this is still the leading winter effect. I'm pretty happy about that. What Balthar needs is to build a luxury intensifier. 995, okay. I'll rush that next turn. I'd like to get that going. And here's that winter. Okay, yeah, so minus diplomatic points is something that I'm totally fine with since we're not getting any. This looks pretty good to me. Let me make sure that this is actually what they were asking for. Science and industry to level 3, yes, okay. Yeah, I like that. Get to keep our plus 3 dust for citizen. We're tearing through this faction quest, that's for sure. The winter actually sucks. We don't. Our armies are not yet winterized. So. Empty belly, you must be even more fearsome. Take this mighty axe with what kind of looks like a Valtar insignia on it. Perhaps the Valtars will find this confusing. Also, I'm going to give him this. He should be faster and more deadly. We still don't have enough glass steel left over that it really makes sense to start equipping our normal units with Eyes of the Farseer yet. Also, why do we have so many eyes? You notice this? We definitely want to set everybody back to dust now. Especially in the capital. Or movement on that that Delver quest. Skyene, what are you doing? What are you thinking, man? Okay. We also need to do research. So what do we need here? We need three techs. this is good. We have a lot of cities that are built up and have multiple districts already, so this will be powerful. This is good for the same reasons. We want a large empire plan. And then, you know, we got a lot of river cities. Let's do that. It's kind of nice not having to worry about food. It simplifies your research decisions somewhat. I'm stealing your pearls, bitch. Oops, that's some of that language I was talking about trying to avoid. Sorry. Yeah. Oh, I suppose we're coming to the end of the video, huh? We probably should be ending the video. You know, I've been looking at how other people do it. People like Quill and Madjin, you know, people who... I'm gonna attack this army right now. People who do strategy game Let's Plays for a living. And I've noticed that, for the most part, they seem to do a lot shorter videos than I do. I like providing the longer videos. I think that, especially in a strategy game, half-hour videos or something like what I see a lot on YouTube, it's just not enough to, like, even have a whole idea occur, you know? If you understand what I'm saying. But if you would prefer that the videos be shorter, I don't even have to release less. I could release 2 half-hours a day if that would be, like, easier for you guys to watch. Leave something in the comments. I don't know if you guys care or not, but if you do have a feeling about that, please let me know so I can better serve the needs of the community. So we got 30 die. That's cool. We like die. We're eating 12 die per turn right now. Next faction quest: capture or destroy the city of Fudoro. This 20 dust orchid combined with the... Didn't we get 20 dust orchid? No. We got the other dust thing, the one that just gives you plus 50% dust output. Where's Fudoro? Because, I mean, we're going to do this, but... It's a question of when, I suppose. I don't see a place called Fudoro. Hopefully Fudoro is a purple territory. That would make things easiest for me. But yeah, let's resolve this battle. We'll set siege to Laldora, and then that's going to be where we end the episode. We'll actually... do the Battle of Laldora at the beginning of next episode. So let's do... Oh, they failed. Okay. That's fine. That's perfectly reasonable, actually. Nope. Set up the siege. We need to increase our siege damage. I think that's definitely a concern. Not like a big concern. Is there anything else important that needs doing this turn? Yes, let us gather more pearls. Because there's never been such a thing as enough pearls. How are we doing on resources? We're capturing so many cities that our resource booster costs are incredibly high. It's really expensive for us to pop boosters. We have the Titan Bones coming in at 6 per turn. We have 9 Moonleaf. I kind of wanna let's have a look at what we got here. Strategic resource income, life on units, initiative, approval. We have three of those villages. It's possible that I should research another assimilation slot and get those eyeless ones, because we're definitely going to be in a position, approval-wise. It always seems like I get to this space with one movement point, doesn't it? I should expand the city down onto the flats, because I believe you can always move between two tiles in the same city, even if there's normally a thing that would normally block your path. And real quick, from dust to rust, it's Palladian. Okay, so we will spend Adamantian to upgrade our troops when we can afford to. We will try to hold up on the Palladian. And then we'll try to cash in on this quest and get it over with as quickly as possible. Alright, well, I guess that's where we're going to call it for today. Alright, I'm going to hit enter. We're gonna call it at the beginning of a turn, as is the case. I've been doing things this way lately, and I'm pretty happy with them. Wait, is that winter effect 0? I thought it was -1. Oh, it's -1 per extractor. All of my extractors were giving 1, so I get no strategic income during winter, right? Well, once I have some more strategic intensifiers, that should stop being the case. In fact, shouldn't I have some income from strategic intensifiers already? Like, doesn't one of the cities down here have one of those? Yeah. Oh, does it only give doubled output when it's level 2, or what's the deal? Anyway, we're calling it here. Come back next time. You know what next time is. Next time is we continue our campaign of violence against Purple. I think we're going to be able to sweep across this southern group of provinces really easily. We're just going to walk our border north one horizontal line at a time until we take them all out. And then once Purple's down, I will consume one of our other neighbors. I don't know. Whichever one is a dick first, I guess. Or whoever has the... whoever has the province of Fudoro. I wish it would at least tell you, like, where. Anyway, come back, watch me do that, and we'll see you then.